friends right here. You know what this is? These are bones of black people that white people that have mutilated right here. You look at these black people right here, they were starved to death. This is what they did. This is a very, very, very difficult thing to understand the truth and significance of the Black Holocaust that we still experience today, because we have paid a hell of a cost and we still continue paying in our ignorance because we refuse to get it out of itself. Go ahead, continue, please. Okay? Now, what I want you to understand is that, and what most people understand is that, when you talk about slavery, a lot of people say, well, Jews, good people have always been our friends. Not true. See, when you got to understand this language, you got to understand the difference between a slave owner and a slave holder. Anybody know the difference between a slave owner and a slave holder? The difference between a slave holder is like, you see, the Jews, they had a lot of money, so they were bankers, right? They were bankers, so they had the majority on capital. So what they would do is they would buy slaves by the thousands. They would buy a lot. So they came up with another business, rent a nigga. So what they would do, they would rent some niggas out, and then other white people, you would live on that, you would take care of the slaves, you would keep another piece, but you had to pay rent to the Jews and their corporations, and they made billions of dollars. And in short time, they made property on slaves. When you look at a lot of companies, they made a lot of money on slaves because they insured the slaves. They insured the slave master. As a matter of fact, Charles and Wesley Brown of Brown University, the Brown Brothers, how they got their money, they transported slaves over here. That's how they did that. They had made money. A lot of people, Goldman Sachs, you know Goldman Sachs, I didn't hear about Goldman Sachs. Goldman Sachs started off the slave trade. You know what? The lie they tell you that white people came over here and some of them did, but you know what most white people came? When they came over here, most Jews, they came to the Mississippi Delta. You know why? Because cotton at that time was just like our oil was there. So they wanted to build an empire on black people. So everywhere Jews went, they went. That's what they did. Because they made a lot of money. A lot of Jews came over here poor, but they had knowledge. Business acumen, so what they were doing, they would send four white brothers over here, they would come down to Mississippi, Louisiana, South Carolina, and they would make money with cotton debt, because at that time, cotton was king. Cotton made a lot of rich people a lot of money. Rockefeller made his money off slave trade. He didn't make it from oil, he made a lot of money somewhere over there, but he got to start in slave trade. Rothschild, they got their stuff in slave trade. So don't tell me the white man don't owe you nothing, because he took everything from you. He took everything, the land, the culture, the God, the concept, everything you do. This is why niggas don't know nothing today. We don't know nothing because we have been robbed and not ourselves. And the Jews, the ones that are so-called best friends, they were the number one betrayer and betrayer of black people. Because now today we talk about the Jews, Negroes trying to copy. They try to compare our suffering with theirs. How can you say just because 6 million Jews may have, because we not say may have, because when I was in school, they said 6 million. Now, some years ago, they said 4 million. Then they come changing, arguing to change to 2 million. Then they said 1 million. Then you got a lot of people in Europe today that say it didn't happen. So if it didn't happen, why would you have to pass a law in Europe that says if you deny the Holocaust, you go to jail? All you got to do is pass over the law, and that's not true. You know what I'm saying? And I'm not saying Hitler didn't kill anybody. I'm not saying that. But at the same time, they're not telling you all the facts. Why they don't tell you that he was a Jew? Why they don't tell you that he wasn't lying? Who else had anything to do with him? A lot of his staff were Catholics, and they were Jewish. They were Jewish. They were being funded by the Nazis and Wall Street Bank. His brother, Max Wahlberg, funded him from Germany. Paul Wahlberg from Wall Street in America. When you look at a lot of financiers in Europe, in China House, they were financiers. They were the ones who brought Hitler to power. They brought Stalin to power. They brought FDR to power. It's the international cabal, which is controlled by Jewish finance. When you look at this, you cannot say this is not a Jewish conspiracy that we're going through. You cannot say that. You cannot say that when black people, you know, when they suffer, that Jews cannot play a pivotal role in our suffering. They have played a pivotal role in our suffering. Just look at it. These are advertisers that talk about to be sold on board of a ship. When you see this, and you see this, and then they let you know some of the representation, they didn't bring dumb people over here. They brought engineers over here. They brought good. See, they had to think that they found you in Africa with bones in your nose. They wanted to think that you were thinking, I don't care how much you be a slave, you cannot make a slave work and produce skills if you don't have any. But what they brought you over here is you engineers. You built the White House. You built Washington, D.C. There was a man named, they called Ben McFadden, as the boy we know as Ben Ali. He was the one who designed Washington, D.C. Based on African principles, based on the Nile Valley. You look at that, that is African. Look at the Washington Monument. The Washington Monument is going to be the Egyptian obelisk. You look at the obelisk, and then you look at the overall, that is the connection of the spiritual and the physical coming together as the masculine and the feminine principles. Come together as a ballroom and the pieces come together to express life. That is just the principle because it's nothing but energy. It has nothing to do with sex. It has to do with interacting with energy. And they understood that. That's why when you look at the Pentagon, right? The Pentagon was the military headquarters of the United States. They call it a Pentagon. The Satanic University and use a pentagram. But you take the 5 points off a pentagram, it's called a Pentagon. Why is the Pentagon pointed at the North Star? Because the ancient Europeans, not ancient Europeans, Europeans believed 1,000 years ago that God of War resided in the North Hemisphere. So therefore, they're pointing at the God of War because they know how to interact with that enemy. Just like I'm showing you those principles, they understand those principles because in politics and in humanity, they use occult science. Because the white man has access to the spiritual world, he has access to the astral. He dreams on these things. So we have a dream too, so we have access to it. But if you don't understand what you're doing, you're going to be unconscious, and he's going to be conscious. So therefore, you have to understand how to work with this energy. That's why everything is based on scientific principles. If you look at the obelisk, you look at the White House, you look at all that. Remember the movie Castle Blanca? That comes from the Sultan of Morocco.